Welcome to Red Rock Canyon National Conservation Area, managed by the Bureau of Land Management. I am your park ranger for the day, Kate Sorum. And today we're going to talk about what used to lay beneath. And by what used to lay beneath, I mean parts of the bottom of the ocean. See those mountains back there? Those are the La Madre Mountains, our gray mountains. The tops of those mountains used to be the bottom of what we now call the Pacific Ocean. So about 500 million years ago, Red Rock Canyon was covered in water. And we know this because we have lots of clues in and around Red Rock Canyon in the form of marine fossils. So today we're going to talk a little bit about our fossils and some of the things that you can find out here. We are filming behind the visitor center, and around this area you can find many things that we are going to talk about today. So let's start with corals. A lot of people think, when they're thinking of fossils, they think dinosaurs, or they think fish or sharks or things like that. Most of what you're going to find out here at Red Rock Canyon are going to be small plant life or seashell type fossils. So we do have coral, which coral we still have in our oceans today. We have lots of coral in and around the Red Rock Canyon area. And if you look closely in the coral, you can find a variety of other types of fossils as well. So here, in the top of this coral bed, we do have another type of plant. We don't have enough of the plant to identify it, but we do know that it's a fossilized plant. So that was a large piece of coral, but sometimes we have smaller pieces of coral as well. This one is about the size of a dime and has spokes that come from the center and go outward, which is one of the ways we identify it as coral in comparison to another animal or fossil that we have out here. When you're out here at Red Rock Canyon, and especially around the visitor center, you are going to find a lot of fossilized algae. It just looks like a brown rocky surface on the tops. Within this rock, the top of it has that blue-green algae fossilized, but you will also find fossilized brachiopods, which are seashells. And speaking of brachiopods, this one's an excellent version of one. So we have, I always use an example of a real seashell, and this one's a scallop shell. And you can see how the ridges go up and down on the scallop. Well, on the fossil of the brachiopod, you see those same ridges. So this is the shell, or the fingerprint, from the shell. And over time, the outer shell disappeared, it dissolved, leaving a fingerprint behind. Sometimes we just find the fingerprints, and sometimes we find the full shell. So we have a couple of shells that certainly look like a clam or a oyster, or maybe even a scallop. And we call those brachiopods. One of the number one fossils, marine fossils, that people think about most often are trilobites. And they wonder if Red Rock Canyon has them. We do have signs of trilobites in the Red Rock Canyon area. And to me, they remind me of roly-polies. Not related to roly-polies in any way, but they do remind me of a roly-poly. And on this particular specimen, you can see where the eyes are at, as well as the spine and the ridge line. Another fossil you can find out at Red Rock Canyon are remnants of sea urchins. Now, sea urchins still live today. The ones I'm familiar with are purple and like porcupines of the ocean. The ones that are out here, when you do find them, they're naked of their porcupine shells. But they are round in color, and they're most definitely look like the sea urchins of today. Now, we've seen a lot of critter type fossils from Red Rock Canyon. We've seen our corals, we've seen our brachiopods, we've seen our fossilized algaes, but we also have one that is most common out here in the form of crinoid stems. Now, crinoid stems grew on the bottom of the ocean. They have a stalk similar to, I guess, a palm tree, but much smaller. And they have ridge lines. To me, when I find them like this, they remind me of rebar. And then at the top of them, to me, it reminds me of a fern that goes upwards. When it's in the ocean, it would spread out. When it's threatened, it closes in together, like you see in the photograph here. Well, we do have our fossilized crinoid stems, not only the stems, which sometimes look again like rebar or even dime-sized, look almost like donuts. This particular rock shows our fossilized crinoid stem. This would be the top of the crinoid, where everything got buried at once, laid down, and this is the fingerprint it left behind. So let's go for a little walk. Okay, so you may be wondering why I have a spray bottle in my hand. So when you're out looking for fossils on a wonderful little fossilized scavenger hunt, a bottle of water will help you to identify some of those fossils. It helps bring out the fossil a little bit more, and I'll demonstrate that shortly. So out here at Red Rock Canyon, other than the corals and the crinoid stems and the brachiopods, you can find sponges. Here's an example of one of our sponges. Just from the surface, it just looks like a regular rock. It's got a little bit of fossilized algae on it, but surprise, when you tip it over, you have the inside of what used to be a sponge. So it's kind of a football shape, if you were to keep it this way. So this one stands upright in this formation, and then over time it would fossilize, and today this is what it looks like. So it's not a soft sponge that we would expect. It's more of a hard rock, but it does have those spongy characteristics. So when you bring out your spray bottle, when you find an area that you think might be fossils, go ahead and spray it. Well, here's our crinoid stem. This had been the stem portion at a crosswise length. Again, you can see some of those ridges in there. And then these would be the same types of crinoid stems, but cut crosswise. And then as you start looking around, you'll see a variety of other types of fossils in the Red Rock Canyon area. And this one right here, you can barely see it, but once we spray it, he stands out pretty well. Let's go see what else we can find. So I've decided to take a seat on the desert floor here at Red Rock Canyon. And just by looking around, if I didn't know better, I would think I'm just surrounded by prickly, pointy cacti that I really don't want to get very friendly with, as well as just rocks. But as I sit here and study what I'm looking at and observe, I realize I am sitting in the middle of a fossil bed. So just this rock area alone has many fossils. We have fossilized algae. That's that blue-green algae I told you about. Looks kind of rough along the rock surfaces. This happens to be sitting on our limestone surface, our gray rock, which this gray rock has a variety of fossils in it as well. So to start with, we're going to start with this, what looks like a hollowed out circle. At one point in time, this was a sponge. So the sponge, I brought the sponge over that I had showed you earlier. Now think about the sponge sitting up just like this. And over time, the inner portion of that sponge disappeared. It biodegraded, it went back into the earth, but it left its outer ring as a fingerprint. So we have a full sponge, and we have just the outer ring of a sponge. In the same area, it looks like just plain rock surface, plain gray rock surface, but as you spray it, things start to happen. We have some fossils here, here. Now, I would guess that these are crinoid stems, but we also have other types of shell-like items that they could be. They could be parts of them could be fossilized oyster. Speaking of oysters, this particular rock that was just sitting here, you never know what you're going to find when you start to observe what's around you. So not only on this large surface of rock do we have our fossilized sponges, we have some crinoid stems, we have fossilized oyster shells. This rock that was just randomly sitting here, I noticed had some stripes in it as well. Well, come to find out, those are also fossilized shells of some kind. Again, it could be an oyster shell, could be some other type of shell, but cross-cut as if you've cut that shell in half. So Red Rock Canyon has a lot of secrets, and we invite you to come out and discover what they are, use your observation skills, and remember what you find here at Red Rock Canyon, you're more than welcome to take pictures of, but everything gets to stay here. They call it home. Thanks for visiting Red Rock Canyon. Have a great day.